Hi, my name is Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about graphing today. This is an overview. So everything I'm doing in the next couple videos has been done on previous videos. This is just another, again, a chance to come and review this a little bit. One of the things that says is which ordered pair is a solution. This is one type of problem you can encounter. When it says which ordered pair, it usually says or pairs is a solution. So it could be several or all of them might be solutions. When you want to know if something is a solution, you plug in the values that you're given. So here I would take where x, I would plug in 0, so 2 times 0, and then for y I'm plugging in 3. And it's a solution if the left side equals the right side. Well, 2 times 0 is 0, minus 9 is 9. Negative 9 does not equal 9, so that's not a solution. If it's a solution, then it will equal. What about the second one? Well, the second one I'm saying 2 times 9 halves minus 3 times 0 equals 9. Well, here I get 9 minus 0 equals 9. 9 equals 9, so yes, this is a solution. Don't stop when you find a solution. Check them all. So 2 times 3 minus 3 times negative 1 is 9. Well, that 2 times 3 is 6, plus 3 is 9. 9 equals 9. That's also a solution. And the last one, I'm saying 2 times 3 halves minus 3 times negative 2 is supposed to be 9. This cancels, giving you 3. Negative 2 times negative 3 is 6, and 9 equals 9. So yes, that is a solution. If it's not a solution, put a strike through it. If it is, circle it, or however you're supposed to enter it. But every ordered pair should be addressed in some way, either yes or no. Don't just do one and then go on. Check them all. Another thing that we're having you do is to give the x and y intercepts for an equation. When you have an x-intercept, you could abbreviate x-intercept with the lowercase letter a, remember that? But when you find an x-intercept, you're asking, if y was 0, what would x be? And when you find the x or the y-intercept, your abbreviation could be b. And you're asking, if x is 0, what would y be? Those are what we're talking about when we're talking about x-intercept and y-intercept. The x-intercept here is, or the y-intercept, excuse me, is very easy. If x is 0, negative 3 times 0 would just fall out, and you'd have y equals 1. So very little work when it's in that format. We know this number at the end, including the sign in front of it, shows us what the y-intercept is. For the x-intercept, though, we have to say, what if y is 0? And then we have to solve this equation. If I subtract 1 from both sides and then divide by negative 3, I find out that my x-intercept is actually 1/3. The equation solved out with an x, but if I was going to state my answer with one letter, I'd have to use a, not x, as my x-intercept abbreviation. For this one, what if I want to know the x-intercept? I'll call it A. Then I make y0. If I want to know the y-intercept, then I make x0. All right, these are the points where the graphs cross the x-axis and the y-axis. That's what the importance of intercepts are. And so if y is 0, negative x, plus 3 times 0 is 6. Negative x is 6. Be careful with your negatives here. X is negative 6. So I have an x-intercept of negative 6. If x is 0, then I have negative 0 plus 3y equals 6. 3y equals 6. Or if I divide both sides by the coefficient, I get y equals 2. So there's my two intercepts. A little trickier is, what if you had x and y equations, vertical and horizontal, and you were asked to find the intercepts? I'm going to go back to some previous notes that I had. If you were asked to give the x and y intercepts for x equals 4, Well, if you take a look at what x equals 4 looks like, it's a vertical line. It crosses the x-axis. Oh. I graphed negative 4. And I'm going to change that. Okay. I graphed x equals negative 4. And so I'm going to put it that way. If x is negative 4, but you can see the x-intercept would be negative 4. And the y-intercept, well, there is none. So here I could say A, or x-intercept, is negative 4, but B is none. There is no y-intercept here. It's never going to cross the y-axis because it's parallel. On the other hand, when you have y equals negative 3, this one I did graph correctly, y equals negative 3 is a horizontal line at negative 3. It's never going to cross the x-axis because it's parallel. So in this case, our A would be none, and B would be negative 3. It crosses the y-axis at negative 3, but it never crosses the x-axis. All right, thanks and have a